I am a staunch follower of the great Shivaji Maharaj and his way of life, wisdom and daring, and how he treated all human beings without being biased or prejudiced. Friends, I have applied a lot of his qualities in my business model, and let me share how his policies can help businesses. We all can use them in the way we do our business. Maximum utilization of scarce resources can be learned from Shivaji Maharaj. Think of the great Shivaji Maharaj and you can never stop admiring how he successfully tackled and defeated great armies with his limited forces. Friends, somehow that's how the corporates today manage to maximize profits in spite of their limited resources. Shivaji Maharaj believed that self-rule encourages business rather than employment. He believed strongly on the format of self-employment. Shivaji Maharaj was one of the few leaders who unified a major part of pre-British India and gave it a symbol of a consolidated single nation. Swaraj or self-rule was a cornerstone of Shivaji Maharaj's ideology, and he was averse to serving other sultanates. Throughout his career, he tried his best to remain independent, only serving larger kingdoms when it made economic and military sense to do so, or if he was forced to do so to save his kingdom. He was a very strategic thinking personality. Friends, Shivaji Maharaj knew that tactics and strategy is better than force and might. There are umpteen examples when Shivaji resorted to guerrilla tactics when faced with a huge opposition. He knew that sometimes the very size of your organization can hinder your ability to control it. In such a situation, many a times, it is easy to create chaos and confuse a large army rather than attack head-on and risk the complete destruction with a small force. Similarly, a smaller sized department or company is much more agile and able to respond quickly to the changes in the market situation. Whether it was defeating the mighty Afzal Khan or whether it was his numerous other confrontations with the Mughals, Shivaji Maharaj never relied only on might to subdue his enemy. Friends, Shivaji Maharaj understood the importance of tactics more than his enemy, and that is what made him such a huge success and a hero to his followers, including me and all of us today. Shivaji Maharaj valued loyalty, but goals were also very important. Shivaji Maharaj valued loyalty and rated it higher than anything else. And at the same time, he believed the goal was more important than loyalty only. Keep in mind that during his younger days, power in the Deccan was shared by three Islamic sultanates, Bijapur, Ahmednagar and Golconda. So Shivaji's father Shahaji was never blindly loyal to any one of them, and he often changed his loyalty between the Nizam Shahi of Ahmednagar, the Adil Shah of Bijapur and the Mughals. Shivaji Maharaj learned a valuable lesson from his father, who always kept his kingdom at Pune along with his own small army, no matter which sultanate he was aligned with. Merit was his only criteria for hiring. Hiring is a critical task for every entrepreneur today. The great Maratha warrior was an intelligent statesman as well, making sure that positions of importance were given only on the basis of merit rather than caste, creed, or religion. Friends, he insisted that all taxes would be collected by government agencies and not by private entities. Also, all civil and military posts were to be transferred from one place or position to another as a matter of principle. No post, even the highest, would be hereditary, and they would be filled only on the basis of merits. A lot of these rules can be seen in government and in the corporate world even today, and will be so forever. In fact, all the qualities discussed are an integral part of any successful entrepreneur. Thanks for watching this video, friends. Do share and add value to the lives of people who look forward to this kind of content. Friends, I'm Agnello Rajesh, Chairman for St. Angelo's VNCT Ventures, and I proudly say that we are one of the largest villa developers of India, developing villas in Thane, which is near Mumbai. We also develop in Chennai, Madurai, and Coimbatore. We have our offices in Dubai, Singapore, and London as well. Our villas come with land ownership and assured progressive rental returns, which help you repay your bank loan EMI, which you have taken for the villa. For more details about us, you can visit us on www.sabbglobal.com, or you can also call us on +91 90 11 22 33 44. Thank you so much.